please sign it to YouTube and subscribe to our YouTube channel and give us a thumbs up. Now enjoy CineTalk with the one and only CineBros.
What's up, Cinemaniacs? We're back with episode number 23. And this is CineTalk, episode 23. And what is CineTalk? CineTalk is where a bunch of movie lovers get together and we talk movies, a.k.a. cinema. And who are some of these movie lovers today? The Cinefeud. We have, first up, we have Sir Chadwick Davis.
Everybody's clapping.
And the mean mugger himself. Brandon Blaine.
He doesn't smile too often.
Brandon Blaine is here in the house as well. And we are here to chat about all sorts of movies. We have, you know, we're going to do the Fuck, Marry, Kill like usual, box office recap, Little Mermaid, a little kind of stuff going on. Also some Disney animated movies, possibly even maybe some other kind of animated films, video games, the new Alice in Wonderland, talking about a little bit, Hateful Eight, Warcraft, Star Wars, Blazing Saddles, a.k.a. Blazing Samurai.
Yeah.
Which you kind of wanted to talk about recently. We got a lot of personal movie shit to talk about.
Let's do it.
So let's get into it. And we're going to start off with the one thing that we always start off with.
Fuck, marry, kill.
And that is, this time we are going to go with, we're going to each give one of our favorite animated movies of all time. We have, we each have a few to choose from just in case they overlap a little bit. We're going to give one each. Then we're going to start off with Brandon here. We're going to go all the way back through. I will go last and then I can choose from whatever's left over from the remains.
I think I did pick South Park in one of my things like the a long time
That is ago. An animated movie, yes.
So that's not a kid's movie.
That is not a kid's movie
Beavis
at all.
Beavis and Butthead to America, not a kid's movie. Yeah. But
Team America?
Yeah.
That's not animated, that's puppets.
That's puppets, man.
But I will pick like a children's-y kind of like animated movie for mine. I'll go Lilo and Stitch.
Ooh, really?
Yeah, I
love
that movie.
Yeah. Okay. All right, Lilo and Stitch to start off with a nice...
I thought you were going to go with South Park. That was my pick.
Yeah.
So, was it really?
South Park is my pick. Yeah.
Wow. See, yeah. When I was thinking about it, I mean, I went straight to like classic old school animated movies. I was thinking Aladdin, Little Mermaid.
Well, mine was Lion King.
Lion King was your all-time favorite animated, like kind of, especially in the kid realm, the kid side of it. But mine is actually one that is not as popular as any of those, and it's a movie that the first movie that I remember like actually welling up and crying to, and that is All Dogs Go to Heaven. It's just one of those movies I remember as a kid watching it and being like, and loving dogs, like I've always had dogs in my family, and you know, you see Charlie like dying and you're kind of like, no. And like just the attachment that he has with like the, you know, the girl, and just everything in general, like Carface, just the whole movie is just great. I have it. I've showed it to my son. He loves the movie as well. And
Remember Oliver and Company?
Yep.
Yeah.
That's a good one.
There's a lot. There's so many good ones, like that are, you know, like the Rescuers, Down Under.
Oh my God.
American Tale.
The Fox and the Hound.
Lady and the Tramp. Yeah. I mean, there's so many good. I mean, even the one. What's the one that? It was the Great Mouse Detective.
Yeah, the Great Mouse Detective.
Oh man, there's so many good ones that are just like, in that next tier that are just so awesome and that just don't get their credit. Don't get the credit that's due. But
I like Surf's Up too. Surf's Up's another.
Surf's
good
Up was
one.
Really
oh,
good.
Wow. I was close to making my list on that. Yeah, one. If we were doing like three and like we each got to like Fuck, Marry, Kill one, like that would have definitely made the list.
Wow. All right. So we'll start out. Let's go right back. Back to Brandon.
I feel bad that you guys went with like like kids movies.
Do you want to switch?
Maybe I should switch it. You can make it a little bit more.
All right. Go ahead.
And I'm not going to go with The Lion King because I think that's pretty easy.
I mean, you could stick a South Park. I mean, that.
Yeah. It was an animated movie.
It's an animated movie.
I'll stick with South Park.
Stick with it.
It's good. I mean, it's great.
It gives us a very, very diverse. Yeah, it's very diverse.
Do I have to go first?
Yeah, you go first.
Yeah, you're going first. This is on you.
What are my choices again?
Lilo and Stitch.
Yeah, yeah.
South Park. All Dogs Go to Heaven.
All right, I'll kill off All Dogs Go to Heaven.
Charlie.
Yeah. I'll marry mine and I'll fuck South Park.
That's a good one. All right. What are you gonna do? Because I think you're definitely gonna have South Park in there.
Yeah. Well, I have to do South Park. I gotta do something to it.
Yeah. You gotta do something to it.
I gotta
get in there at some point.
This is gonna sound really weird, but I'm actually gonna kill off South Park.
Whoa!
Because I pretty much can quote that fucking movie to the end.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so.
Can we do it again?
I got it implanted in my head. Yeah, remember he comes up over starts singing the song, you know? Yeah, I mean, yeah. I'm gonna have to kill it off.
Kill off your own movie.
Yeah. Oh man.
I could kill off.
And this is gonna be the real bad part because the other two movies I wasn't huge on.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
huge.
It's fucking huge. I don't like dogs, so I'm just gonna have to use that. I know.
That's your basis.
I don't like dogs. I mean. I'm not a dog fan.
And now to our sponsor, Petco.
Yeah. No, I like animals, like some animals. I just don't like cats or dogs or...
Yeah, the dog whisperer over here. And...
was Cesar Chavez?
Milan.
Whatever.
Cesar Chavez?
Yeah, that was. Like, isn't that the guy that helped the Mexicans? Like,
isn't that like a drug
the
guy?
Workforce?
Cesar, yeah.
Which was a good movie, by the way.
He's even the guy on the t-shirts with the star.
Oh my gosh!
All right, so I'm gonna have to marry Lilo and Stitch, I guess.
Yeah, and just.
I guess so. Yeah.
Wow, even though your dislike for dogs.
I just fucked the dogs one weekend. This is weird.
You made it weird. No one else is talking about that.
No. I'm gonna fuck all the dogs that go to heaven then.
I'm gonna fuck the dogs to heaven. That's just gonna happen.
Oh my gosh! Oh fucking!
Leave it up to me to make. All
right,
weird.
Yeah, this got real weird real fast. All right, so I'm gonna do similar to what you did, but I'm gonna marry my all dogs go to heaven.
Yeah.
I will have South Park for that weekend just because watching a kid movie over and over and over again can kind of, I don't know, you need a little difference, and I think South Park will. Yeah. Get their, get all the vulgarity that I need in a movie.
Definitely will get that.
Yes, and you get it in abundance. So I think I'll go with, I'll marry that.
I think with like some of the older movies that came out, some of the older classic movies, they didn't have really like adult humor in them. Like
right.
A lot of the newer ones now are really great at like walking that line. Mm-hmm. Despicable Me, like Shrek. Shrek. Yeah, like a lot of
Toy
like,
Story,
all
of them. All
like the newer ones.
Incredibles. Incredibles is basically a movie for adults.
Yeah.
It just has that. Mm-hmm. Fun flair for kids. Right. I mean, it's just
they've gotten a lot better, a lot easy. They've eased up on you know, super kiddie and making it fun for
making it movie theater friendly for adults,
to be there
right?
Well,
yeah.
So they have to sit there and be bored.
And, be bored out of their minds. Yeah. And this way, they'll get them to come back more often. Like, he wants to see the Lego movie again. Okay, great. Yeah, that's
exactly.
Great. That sounds good.
Hell yeah.
So, all right, we're gonna move on. We're gonna move on to the next topic, our segment here, and the next segment is. New news is basically where we're going to get a couple of minutes here to talk about the new news. And the first topic up is a box office recap. We kind of do this every Monday when we film. And that is, I'm going to read off the top five at the box office, but we can go into it about the top 10 or so. All right, so the estimates are that Spectre finished with $73 million, a little lower than I thought it was going to be. The Peanuts movie came in second with $45 million. The Martian finished third, which is, it's been sitting at number one forever. And it still did $9.3 million. Goosebumps comes in fourth at $6.9 million. And Bridge of Spies, which I'm shocked, but... what I picked for my number five is at $6.0 million. So those are the top five at the box office. I mean, I there wasn't much that I was shocked about when it comes to this. I mean, I did my predictions last Thursday. I got 5 for 5. I predicted the top two to do a little better. I think I predicted like Spectre to do about $92 million. I think I had Peanuts at like 50, mm-hmm. 52. I thought it was going to do a little bit better because the box office lately has just kind of been stagnant and low, and just not a lot of people have been going out because not a lot of good movies have been coming out. But I was shocked that Bridge of Spies did so well. I had predicted it to be fifth, but I had only predicted it to do like $3.8 million, which still would have put it in the fifth spot. But
yeah. I'm just happy people are going to the movies this weekend. I mean,
seriously,
because it's been a drought, like big time. I think since July 17th, it's been that was when the second biggest area had been when Ant-Man came out. Mm-hmm.
I mean, The Martian had a big opening, but
yeah.
not...
Yeah, but the weekend... Not I'm, two. I meant the weekend gross total for all the movies together. It didn't even come close. It was $60 million more than The Martian opening weekend.
Yeah.
I mean, and it was the biggest jump since Age of Ultron from week to week. It was, what, 122% more from last week. Mm-hmm. And I think Avengers did like 130-something percent.
Yeah. I mean, it's amazing with like the 3, 4, and 5 like place movies. They've been in there for 4 to 5, 6 weeks range.
Number
like,
6 too, Hotel Transylvania 2 has been around since.
It's been forever, and they're still like they're only dropping 20 to 30% like the intern, every week.
The intern's been in there for 7 weeks,
And it's still in the top 10. I mean, it's amazing. Yeah. Like, I mean, the one thing that I'm sad about though still is that Goosebumps still hasn't made money. I mean, it's. Production budget, and it hasn't crossed the 100 million point yet, and it needs to probably get to like 160 to start making a profit.
I said the budget was 58.
Yeah, and I don't
66 right now 66. For like a total gross.
No, it's not good at all. I mean, this is, I don't know if it's released in Japan or China, which are other two kind of bigger markets, China especially. Yeah. But I don't even know how much big of a market it's going to have over there. It's I enjoyed the movie for what it was.
Yeah.
The one of the complaints that some people had was that the special effects, the CG, wasn't very good.
Yeah.
And whatever. I mean, it is what it is. I mean, it's not the greatest CG in the world. I wasn't expecting that. I was expecting to be more of like a kid kind of CG work. You don't want it to be overly scary.
Right.
Like, I don't know. I thought they did a good job with it, and it is what it is. I don't know. I was hoping to get another movie from this franchise, it's not looking like it's gonna. It's not looking unless it does big numbers overseas somewhere. Nah. It doesn't look like it.
Sony will scrap that.
Yeah. All right. So we will move on to our actual first topic here, and the first topic, it's pretty much official news that Chloe Grace Moretz is set. That is Kick-Ass, Hit Girl, and is set to play the title character in The Little Mermaid, which is a live-action retelling. Which Richard Curtis, who's done movies like Mr. Bean movies, Notting Hill, Bridget Jones' Diary, and War Horse, is in talks to write the adaptation of the 1989 animated film. Are you excited for this film and the leading lady or even Richard Curtis, like being in talks to pen the movie? I'll start off with Chad because I know he has love for the animated classics, but I don't know how much love he has for the live action adaptations.
Well, I mean, I think I might be into this one. I mean, it's going to be dark. I mean, it's going to be the Hans Christian Andersen version of it. It's not the Disney, like, kind of fluffy. Kind of, it's gonna
the
be
the movie was dark. Amazing.
It's gonna be kind of dark. No, I'm not saying Little
and
Mermaid.
And there was dark parts. I mean, Ursula was one of the most menacing.
I think this is gonna be a little bit darker than what people are gonna expect. I love the decision to have her as Ariel. I mean, she was awesome in Kick-Ass. I mean, that was one of my favorite movies. So
yeah,
she's cool. And Richard Curtis, the movies that I've seen that he's done, because he did Pirate Radio too.
Okay.
And I love that movie. And I'm a big Bean fan, so yeah. I love Mr. Bean and Mr. Bean. I don't think he did the second one, but...
He's done a few of them.
He did both of them?
He's done a few movies. I don't know how many Mr. Bean movies there are out there.
Like two actual American Bean ones.
Has there? Yeah. He might have written the stuff overseas, too. Yeah, I know he's done some TV stuff as well, but...
But I've never seen his other movies. I mean, the other movies don't seem like they're kind of movies that... are relatable to
Warhorse is Oscar winner,
but like
Oscar nominated
Notting Hill Love Actually Diary, I mean, he's done really good movies. These movies are like,
I love Notting Hill. Like, I thought that movie was very well written. Same thing with Bridget Jones' Diary. Like, I'm not a big Bridget Jones' Diary fan, but I loved the dynamic that they had with the three like Colin Firth and I can't remember who the other Hugh Grant I think was the other one and Renee Zellweger. I love the dynamic they had with them, so I think that I'm very excited for Richard Curtis to pen the script. Mm-hmm. Because I think he's just got a great wit about him, and he can give you some humor on top of creating some drama and all that kind of stuff. He just does a really good job with it. With Chloe Grace Moretz, I mean, she's a great actress. Mm-hmm. She's got a little star power. You know, all, although The Little Mermaid is one of my more favorite animated movies,
right.
Yep. I'm not super excited about this yet.
Yeah,
me either. I think, I don't know, I'm just kind of mildly excited for it. Like, I'm not, I don't know why. I don't know why I haven't really gotten really into
There's
it.
There's so
yet,
much coming out, that's why I think.
There is a lot.
Do you think it's going to get to the point where it's like going to be oversaturated with. Where people are not going to get excited over these movies anymore? I mean,
well, this is like the, the third kind of, well, fourth maybe, the kind of live action retail. You have Maleficent.
You have the Alice in Wonderland movies.
That one too.
Cinderella. Yeah.
Snow White, the Witch Hunter, the one where Kristen Stewart's in it.
Was it called Snow White? I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, so this is like, you know, they're starting to like really get, you know, these live action kind of things, like retellings and stuff, and they're doing really well.
Yeah, but
if this is going to be if it's going to be a retelling of the Disney film, then I would be probably a little bit more excited for it.
Yeah.
But I don't think it is. I think he's going to take its own, you know, course and its own action and things like that. I love the Little Mermaid is, you know, classic for the Disney way of being and things like that. So I think it's going to be up against, you know, kind of a tough wall to knock down, because it's iconic. Cinderella is two, and they've done, you know, they did
that
a
was
really
amazing
great
movie.
Job
was
at that, you know what I mean? Yeah. So if like they take that same approach, like it would be cool. And there's Beauty and the Beast is coming out next year too.
Jungle Book.
Emma Watson's gonna be Belle, and like I'm interested to see how that unfolds, like on as a live screen, you know, and live action kind of a movie, but. As far as this one goes, I'm still like, I don't know, I'm just kind of on the fence about it.
Yeah, I don't know why.
I'm just excited. I just want to see how they handle it.
I'm kind of excited for that, but yeah. I don't know. There's just something about it that nothing's really popped at me yet. Maybe when they get a director.
Is there going to be a Jamaican talking crab? Like
that would be great.
You know what I mean?
I want to know if they stick to the book. I mean, you know the book's ending. She dies in the ending.
Yeah.
I want to see like.
In the book I have. The one I have is like real short. And then she just swims away. Like it's like a kid.
In this version of it, she dies. I don't think they're going to keep that. I think they're going to.
Yeah,
probably veer away.
They might want a sequel.
You know how many people? You know how many people are don't understand that it's not Disney. Like you go online and like it's crazy how people. I can't believe they're doing this to a Disney movie. Like putting her in.
Neither one is like it's the initial Disney movie. The initial tension of Frozen either. Mm. That was supposed to be a Hans Christian Andersen adaptation too.
Yeah. Mm.
All right. Well, we're gonna have to move on to the next topic. We will go on to the next one, which is. With the Warcraft movie coming out, we just got a trailer for it recently, which we'll be talking about soon. With it coming out next year, if it does well, Assassin's Creed coming, I think there's a Call of Duty movie coming out. There's just a bunch of different movies that are coming out. With all of these that are in the works, which video games would you like to see brought to the live action realm? Hmm. You can even go with ones that have already been done, but just not done well.
Yeah.
You can do whatever you want. We'll start off with Brandon on this one because
I got a good one. I want to see what you.
I'll start off
with
Brandon.
I'm excited for the World of Warcraft thing to come out. Yeah. We'll talk about that probably a little bit later. But I don't know. I'd really like to see maybe them do maybe a Mario Brothers movie. Better because my love for the '90s is as big as anyone else's is.
Yeah,
and I actually don't. Hate the John Leguizamo Dennis Hopper one, even though it's really bad. It's a guilty pleasure movie. Like I like it, but like if they did that one well, or maybe like a cool Zelda movie, like a Link, you know, kind of shot it Lord of the Rings style, you know, kind of thing like that.
That'd be cool.
You know, I think that would be kind of cool.
There was talks a while ago about to do a Zelda movie, and I haven't heard much. You know, since like in the last probably 6 months, but like there about a year ago, I remember there being some talk.
Its fan base is so solid, like even with like, you know, retro gamers and like everything else with, you know, you go into Hot Topic or like stores like that and they're still selling like, you know, a bunch of like Link and like Zelda like stuff. So like the stuff, you know, I think the interest would be out there to kind of see how it would go.
All right. Maybe. What do you think, Mr. Chad?
I mean, growing up, I played mostly, and I still do, just play mostly sports
I want a live
games.
Live action duck hunt game.
like, look at the dog coming up. No. I mean, I played a lot of sports games. I played RBI baseball. I played Bases Loaded. Oh, played those are Double great Dribble. Games. Yeah. Like, I don't see movies coming out of those.
Super Tecmo Bowl.
But the one game that was non-sports that I played all the time, and I probably played the first like 10 to the end, was Mega Man.
Mega Man. All right.
I would like to see a Mega Man movie, like live action Mega Man movie.
Yeah, there's some cool ones that you could come out with. I mean, I think like Contra could be a really cool game.
Yeah, Contra, yeah.
That could be a cool one. That's like an Double old Dragon. 90s game. Double Dragon.
They had one. It was bad.
The guy who does he's on the Iron Chef, guy that does the flips, and he's like the only Asian guy, even though I'm related to this. He was my uncle. He wasn't, but that guy was actually in the movie as one of the characters. The movies, see, mine is kind of different because there is one that has video games, but it started more off as a cartoon. And that's Yu-Gi-Oh. Okay. I think that could play out really well if you did like more of like a live action dark kind of tone of a movie, because me and my brother have always talked about like locking ourselves in a room for a weekend and penning a script and all that kind of stuff, because there's just so much that you could do with that, with the monsters, the dual monsters, and the storytelling and the line. Like, there's just so much that you could go off of. But other movies like Tekken, I could see that. I always loved playing that game to follow the storyline.
Do you think they would do that? Because like Mortal Kombat, like, you know, with the
there is more of, you have more story to tell in like a Mortal Kombat because it's science fiction. I mean, there's just other world realms and all that kind of stuff. Whereas Tekken, and I think that's, I would like to see it because I love the story that you would see play out as you're playing the game.
Okay.
But I could see why they wouldn't want to do it, because obviously Mortal Kombat, The Annihilation didn't do very well. Yeah. Wasn't a very good movie. Yeah. I enjoyed it, but it's more of a guilty pleasure.
Yeah.
The first Mortal Kombat was good. It was fun, but it's still kind of a guilty pleasure.
Did you like Street Fighter?
The Van Damme or the Chun-Li?
The Van Damme.
Van Damme, I enjoyed it as a guilty pleasure. Yeah. Like, I could watch that and just smile from ear to ear and laugh at it.
The Raul Julia is Bison.
Oh, my God. It's so good, but so bad.
How about a Paperboy movie? Where just the movie was just him delivering papers and like avoiding twisters.
Oh,
and
Jesus.
Dogs running after him. Hour and a half.
90 minutes.
Shit, I lost another subscriber.
So we're going to go right into the next segment, and that is
In or Out of the Movie Trailer Park.
And that is In and Out of the Movie Trailer Park is where we each come up with our own trailers, and that's come out in the last week or so, and we tell you if we're in or out based on the trailers. Most of the trailers you can find on Movie Clips. And if you can't, I'm sure you can find it. It's not that hard. You know how to use Google. You know how to use YouTube.
Nobody knows how to use YouTube
because we only have 118 subscribers. Yeah. So God damn it, subscribe.
There's a little red tab.
You see over here, like right where RoboCop is, there's a little thing right below him. You just click on that and you can subscribe to our channel. That's enough begging for now. So we're going to go on to Chad's first trailer.
A pinch of butthurt in there, I think.
So we're going to go into Chad's first trailer, and that is Alice Through the Looking Glass.
That's because I stole the one he would have picked.
No, this was mine. From the first.
I disagree.
No, I didn't really
watch. I chimed in real quick, like, which ones you want to use? I'm like, I want this one.
I picked mine before I even saw the trailer. I knew it when it was coming out, and I was like, this is the one I want.
We just talked about the first trailer not too long ago, so for the Hateful Eight.
Right, right. Yeah. Well, I mean,
you were super excited about it, so that's why.
I tried
to grab it, so you couldn't talk about it.
All right, so this is
I can find a trailer.
This is the synopsis for Alice Through the Looking Glass. When Alice wakes up in Wonderland, she must travel through a mysterious new world to retrieve a magical scepter that can stop the evil Lord of Time before he turns forward the clock and turns Wonderland into a barren, lifeless old world. With the help of some new friends, Alice must also uncover an evil plot to the Queen of Hearts back on the throne. So, I mean, it's pretty accurate.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Chad. Go ahead, Sir Chadwick. Give us what you got.
I'm all in. I mean, I love the first one. I know it's been mixed reviews, and this one's getting mixed reviews already. Mm-hmm. And I love the first one. I mean, Johnny Depp was awesome in it as the Mad Hatter. Anne Hathaway was good in it. I'm looking forward to Sacha Baron Cohen in this one as
Bowen?
Baron Bowen, whatever the fuck his name is. You guys know who I'm talking about. as time. I should have just called him Sasha, huh? Yeah, Sasha. Just Sasha.
Sasha BC.
Yeah. I'm looking forward to seeing Borat. Him. I'm looking forward to seeing him in this, too. I mean, it looks good.
Excellent. Yeah. All right. So what about you? What about you, Brandon? What do you have to say? You have to say for yourself.
I think the Through the Looking Glass would be good. It's not going to take me out to theaters to go see it. But if it was something that popped into Netflix or you know, on TV or on demand or whatever, I'd definitely watch it. I did watch the first one. I thought it was good. I'm a big fan of Johnny Depp. I think he's one of the, if not the best actors in my generation. I love a lot of, you know, what he does. Most of his stuff is gold for me, minus the last five Jack Sparrow movies or something like that. I'll give him the first couple, but like, I just want the franchise to go away by now.
I love that franchise.
I know you do. That's a little something I could send your way that you can rebut.
Well, I mean, for me, I thought that this trailer actually got me a little excited to actually watch the first one. I still have yet to see the first one.
So good.
I like it.
I haven't watched it. I don't. I've heard a couple of good things.
Anne Hathaway, I did like her performance in it, but the way she looks. As being like super white and really pale,
yeah.
It just kind of takes me away from it, from her, like a little bit. But she, I mean, she's great.
I thought so, the Red Queen. I can't remember.
Helena Bonham Carter is like so good.
Oh my god!
Well, like, and that's what I have to say. And that like, as far as like Johnny Depp in this movie, it takes me out of it. Like his clowny costume makeup stuff. It's just starting to like get me aggravated. Yeah. Like I'm getting annoyed with all of these different looks that all I can see is just a cartoonish look of Johnny Depp. I don't want to see it anymore. Yeah, I'm tired of it.
What is Jack Sparrow? Jack Sparrow's a clown without makeup.
It's more makeup than anything. It's not, though. I mean, it just looks like a person. Like,
do you think Jack Sparrow looks like a person?
Yes. I feel like he looks like a person.
A clown. He's a clown without
looks like a pirate.
On.
He looks like a pirate.
Clown.
He looks like a clown pirate. Hashtag clown pirate. But anyway, I think that...
nowadays look like him?
Yeah.
But no, not nowadays. This is set back in the... Weirdo.
This is an alternate time.
Yes. But Helena Bonham Carter. Now I'm getting
Hell Boner.
We'll say HBC, the Heartbreak Kid. Or no, that's not even that. HBC looks great.
HBC is not Heartbreak.
No, it's I was child.
Heartbreak Child.
looked great. And I think that she plays that animated character really, really well. Like I thought that her performance in just the trailer was enough to sell me on the movie, whereas Johnny Depp, I saw and I was like, I just want to shut this off. So I'm in, but I'm not like firmly in. Anybody else in?
I'm in.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna. Yeah, like I said, I'm
he's not into the movie theater.
Yeah, I'm not into the theater to see it, but I'm glad it's, you know,
you'll watch
or whatever.
It.
I'll watch it.
All right,
eventually.
All right, so the next one up is the Blaine's trailer, and that is The Hateful Eight, which we have talked about already, like that he's picked it. And I will give you the little synopsis if I can open up my phone. Right now, in post-Civil War Wyoming, bounty hunters try to shelter during a blizzard but get involved in a plot of betrayal and deception. Will they survive?
Dun, dun, dun.
So, Mr. Blaine.
Yes.
Go ahead. What do you got? What you got for us?
I actually may go into the theater to watch this one, so it's something that, you know, will go get me out to go see it, you know what I mean? I love Quentin Tarantino. I love a lot of the stuff that he's even just involved in, not even in a directorial like role, when he's, you know, teamed up with like Robert Rodriguez and stuff in the past, Desperado, like even in, like a small little cameo like that, like I just dig it. Kill Bill movies, I love them, you know. And I love the, you know, he keeps a lot of the same actors around him because he knows he can get, you know, what he wants and the
great performances
out of them and things like that. With like, you know, Michael Madsen and like obviously Samuel L. Jackson and stuff like that. But he has like a bunch of other people that, you know, I think are great actors or are like on their way to becoming like the next movie star kind of actors, like Walton Goggins is his name. He's been in a bunch of he's been in like The Shield, or was it Justice, a lot of FX shows. He was in Sons of Anarchy too. He's a great actor, and I think for him to start getting some like silver screen like bigger appeal, I think is great. Kurt Russell looks like he's, you know, queued up to do a great role. I know you're a fan of his.
I am. I do like Kurt Russell.
And stuff like that. So, like, it just looks cool how, like, this is going to be the prime. They're in this one location for this spot, and they're going to, you know, obviously probably show some spin-off backstories. Yep. But then, you know, how his ability to write conflict in, like, a closed space and to show it. Like, look at you, Kill Bill, in that one action scene where they're all in that one place. All these different things take place at a different time where she goes down to the bathroom and she's talking to the girl or whatever. Like, I'm not kind of getting off topic, but I'm not. Like, you know, I'm just, you know, there's this all this conflict in this one specific place that I think that is going to tell that story, like, really well.
Okay. What do you think, Chad?
I'm all in. I mean, this just made me more excited for it. The first trailer got me excited. This one, I think this is going to be in my top three movies of the year. Yeah. Just not even watching the movie yet. I thought Jennifer Jason, I think she's going to be fucking hilarious in it. She looked like she's going to be hilarious.
She has that one moment in the movie where she
I laugh every time I see it. Like, I'm like, oh, this is going to be good. And I'm waiting. It's going to be a bloodbath, like, at some point, and I can't wait for it.
Yeah, I mean, with all the controversy that's surrounding this, too, with Quentin Tarantino's, you know, he's come out recently and talked about, like, had some words to say about cops and police and all that kind of stuff. And he's got a lot of everything with that and just a lot of hype just around Quentin Tarantino movies in general. I mean, I think it's going to do really well. But I haven't really enjoyed the trailers so much. Like, I thought the first one, the really short clip, it was good. It was shot very well. The 70 millimeter thing that they put at the end always cracks me up. But I haven't really enjoyed the trailers because I haven't really gotten a good take on the chemistry between all the characters. I see a lot of this guy speaking, then this guy speaking, and then this guy speaking, which kind of bums me out. Like, I want to see an interaction to get that feeling in me, like, shit is gonna go down. Like, they're all saying stuff, but I don't even know who they're really talking to half the time, you know? So I don't get a lot of that. So that kind of bugs me a little bit. I'm in on this movie because it's a movie. I feel like I say that about every Quentin Tarantino movie, which I like probably about half of them. But there's such a good chance that with this, especially with this cast,
and it looks
it
great.
Could be another
the picture itself.
Just looks, I want to try and
Quentin Tarantino movies.
I was gonna ask the same thing, but
I don't like Reservoir Dogs.
Wow.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I don't. I'm like,
what, Jackie Brown, maybe?
Jackie Brown. I
even like that one.
I don't mind.
It's okay. But yeah, like, I mean, Kill Bill was good, but
do you like Django?
I liked Django, but I didn't like Jamie Foxx in Django.
Wow.
Sin City?
No.
You didn't like it?
No. I actually disliked that movie a lot.
Do you like? Just because of the way it was shot, like,
I didn't like the way it was shot. I didn't like how the story was told.
Did you like it?
I did.
Yeah.
I mean, he didn't really direct that, right?
Yes, he did.
He did direct that. I thought it was Rodriguez that directed that.
It's on his thing.
I thought he was just like a maybe. He had like maybe he directed part of it.
Did you see Grindhouse? Like the
no,
two?
No.
Four Rooms.
Yep.
You haven't seen it?
No,
that was probably one
it.
Of the
haven't
ones that
it.
I
haven't
didn't,
seen it?
Didn't like.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Well, it's really disjointed because, I mean, I
wasn't really into that one, but.
Yeah, no, Sin City is one of those movies that I actually almost walked out of.
Really?
Yeah, I really disliked it.
Wow.
All right, so we're going to go on to the next topic here, and that or the next, next trailer. And that is mine, which is the Warcraft movie trailer. Mm-hmm. I will read a quick synopsis, if I can type it up quick. And this is, the film portrays the origin story of the initial encounters between the humans and the orcs, with an emphasis upon both the alliances and the horde sides of their conflict, featuring characters such as Durotan and Lothar. The film will take place in a variety of locations established in the video game series. Now, I don't know anything about the video game at all. I've never played it.
Yeah.
I know a lot of people, a lot of friends of mine who were addicted to the game and, you know, would come out looking very straggly and all kind of messed up a little bit. But
do you remember you ever watch a South Park episode where they do like that?
Yeah,
I actually saw a YouTube clip of that.
Guy, just
and like the kids get all fat and pimply.
Yeah.
So funny.
Yeah.
And they gave you the they gave you like a free 30-day subscription. Like Warcraft like sponsored like that episode.
Wow.
And they gave you, you could go like for a free trial like after that like, episode aired.
Yeah, they almost tried to make it look cool. Like, you know, like it's cool to be, you know, kids, a hermit in your in your basement playing games.
The characters in the game are all like
jacked up. They're all jacked up. Looked like them and everything. Yeah, it was pretty funny.
So, I mean, I think that, you know, this trailer.
Yeah.
I watched this. I like I said, I had called this trailer out 2 days before it even dropped. I was like, I'm going to do this trailer. You guys pick what you're going to pick. Even though I don't know what this trailer is going to look like. I saw a poster and that's all I saw. But with the CG mixed with the practical effects, I think looks amazing. The thing looks almost like on a grand scale. It just, I'm so psyched to see this movie now. And I can't say that I was super amped up to see it. I was kind of excited to see what happens with it because I want to see like game to movie adaptations happen.
Right.
Because I feel like if these studios put some money into these movies, like if they put their money into a Mortal Kombat, they put their money into like the Assassin's Creed that's coming out, you could make a really cool movie.
Yeah.
There is a chance that you could be a total flop. Like, but still, I mean, it's, With all the worlds and everything, and it's how popular they become, I can see this movie doing really, really well and spawning multiple movies after it. And just with the trailer, totally in. I'm totally in on this. I can't wait to see it. What about you, Chad?
It's very heavily CGI'd, which, you know, I'm not a huge fan of, but for a movie like this, I think you have to go that way.
Well, I mean, you have orcs.
You have to, yeah.
Huge.
So, I liked it. I mean,
and I think that those orcs are part practical effect as well. I don't think they're full. They look human almost. I mean,
like the main guy that did look like there was.
He has like a human kind of element to his face. So it's just, I think the way that they did it was really good.
I'm in, but I'm just worried about the CGI and what the budget is and how well it's going to be done. And it could be really corny and or it could be really good. I don't know. I mean,
I can't wait to see some of these battles.
Warcraft anyway, but
yeah, I've never played it.
But I do like the movie. I mean, the movie looked like it was going to be interesting and good. So,
all right, what do you think, Brandon?
I have played it. It's also the most popular video game ever.
Yeah,
ever. Like, or most
profitable.
Yeah, profitable 22. Yeah. So I think that's going to really draw out the horde of people. To
yes.
go see it.
See what you did there.
But like the CG that you see in the trailer and stuff is extensive, but it's good.
Really good.
It's good. The texturing on their skin,
it's like Planet of the Apes.
Lighting, it's very very good. So it's hard to like. It's not hard. I mean, it is hard to do that, you know, but like to do it well. It
costs money.
It costs a lot of money. Yeah. So like that. It
seems like they put the investment in, which is nice. I'm glad to see that.
Hopefully they do.
I want to see more of it. You know, like there's some times where you don't want to see more before you go out and see a movie. Like this, I do want to see another couple trailers, another TV spot, like something like that to kind of, you know.
It's like a clip or something.
Yeah, just to kind of like, you know, give me a little bit more of the story, like, you know, the dying world, come do that. Like, I get that, and I'm in so far.
All right, great.
I want to see more.
Awesome. So is that all three in, but you're kind of on the fence a little?
No, I'm in.
You're in? You're
I'm just worried.
Right. You're just worried a little bit?
I'm in, but I'm worried.
I'm reluctant. All right, now the last one up is we're just going to briefly discuss the Star Wars International trailer. This is something that Brandon kind of had mentioned that he wanted to kind of chat a little bit, I think because he knows that I was a little upset with it originally.
Yeah. Well,
but
I know how you feel about these things in general. Right. So, and Brian's not here, and I wanted to wear my
Kylo Ren.
I wore a Kylo Ren shirt just because
Hashtag Brian's Kylo absent. Crazy, as he likes to say all the time. He's buying everything Kylo Ren. I hope for his sake he doesn't die off in the first movie. That would be horrible.
Oh, that would be bad.
Oh man,
I don't think he'd still mind.
Lots of stuff would be going on
auction. The next thing he'll want to buy that.
So we're gonna talk about this real quick. We'll start off with the person who I know loves Star Wars more than everybody, and that is Chadwick.
I was gonna let you guys like go at it.
No.
I watched it and I didn't get any emotions out of it or anything. I mean,
Did you think that it did you like the trailer? Did it get you more excited for the movie?
I like this one. I mean, it didn't get me more excited for the movie. I mean, maybe after I'm done watching the other movies, maybe I will get excited, but
all right.
How far are you into that so far?
First one.
Oh yeah, I knew.
I'm gonna let him borrow my Blu-rays right when he leaves.
Technically, episode 4.
No.
I have all of them too.
Like, I'm going 4, 5, 1 through 6. 3, 6.
All right.
That's the order I'm going in.
All right. Excellent. Mm-hmm. All right, so what do you think? What did you think about this trailer?
I liked it. Mm-hmm. I'm almost in agreement with you about it.
Yeah.
Only being the fact that if they hadn't released the other one and this was the one that they released,
yeah,
you wouldn't feel the way you do about it.
Okay.
Because this did show a lot of the similar stuff. Mm-hmm. It did show you a couple other things, like it looks like Chewie's the one that blows up that bridge of the other ship because you see him pressing the button, and you get the cool shot of Daisy, or was it or
Daisy Ridley?
Yeah, what's her? I can't remember.
Ray.
Yeah, you see Ray on her knees, and Kylo Ren's got the lightsaber like right at her throat,
mm-hmm.
which is a cool shot that
yeah.
you're probably most pissed about, because you, but it's something that you know. I probably could have done without seeing it as well, because that's where I will segue kind of to you about it. It's starting to become a bit much. I'll actually come to your side of the thing and saying with the TV spot that came out and stuff like that. Like,
did you watch it?
Yeah, I watched it. I sent it to you and you didn't watch it.
Nope.
You posted it. But like,
yeah.
I watched it and I'm just like, all right, like I just want, it's not that I'm upset with the machine because that's the way it's been done and things like that. I'm just ready for it to come out already. Like,
yeah.
The anticipation is already there for me. You can't hype me up more to go see the movie anyway.
Got a week.
Because we're going.
Nope.
We're going already. You know what I mean? Yep. So, like, that to me is.
I think that just with the original, the first couple of trailers, they did such a good job of leaving a lot to the imagination at the same time as getting you hyped up for the movie.
Right.
And then they. Now they're giving us like these little glimpses like they did with the Kylo Ren and the Rey kind of, you know, lightsaber up to the neck. And and she's just sitting there kind of like terrified for her life. I don't think she's dying. I don't need to see that scene.
Yeah.
I would have had much more tension seeing that play out on the big screen rather than watching that in a trailer. Like, I did not need that. We got the, you know, Finn versus Kylo Ren going up against each other in the other trailer. We don't need this one as well. You don't need to do that. I don't know why they have to kind of do these international trailers and make them so much different. I don't know if it, you know, obviously their work that they do in the background tells them that this will sell better in, you know, Europe if the lightsaber is at, you know, her neck instead of Finn. I don't know what the deal is that they need this, because I just feel like that first trailer that they gave us was so, what, like the real trailer that they posted for Super Bowl was so well done.
Night football.
Yeah, for, yeah, whatever. They did such
a nerd Super Bowl. That's a good thought.
Yeah. Is that what I said, Super Bowl? Did I say Super Bowl?
It's
but they did they did such a good job with the build up, getting people excited. I wouldn't have minded if they did the TV spot and just let no international trailer. Use that one that we got as the international trailer.
But you just see
the worldwide trailer.
The big differences of where they went with, like, even the poster, like the international poster is completely different. There's a lot less characters, and Kylo Ren is the focus.
Right.
So that extra shot of Kylo Ren, they're thinking maybe we got to do that because, like, there's such a buzz about him and, you know, such whatever about Finn or Daisy or Rey isn't as much, you know what I mean? So, like,
I just don't know. I don't want any more. I know that this is what Disney does, and lately, especially with like all their big blockbuster franchises, I think it ruined Ultron, and I think that's why it didn't do as well.
I disagree with that. I think the story was bad.
Well,
and there's holes in the story, and James Spader's like little
quirkiness. He kind of ruined it. But like, I think that they sold you as him being this kind of big, badass, dark character.
Yeah.
He's kind of a jokester, you know? Like, and it's like, weird. Like, I don't want to see that. Like, just tell me what you're going to give me, and then, but do it in a way that you're kind of leaving stuff to your imagination. Don't sell me on one thing and then pull the rug out. Like, I don't want to go there and see like Kylo Ren be this kind of funny guy, you know? I don't want that. I want Kylo Ren to be this dark, badass, brooding, you know, evil villain, and I hope that's what we get. But I don't know. I'm gonna go off on a tangent.
You talked about the TV spot a little bit. Do you want me to talk about it since I watched it, or do you just want to leave it to the posters to go check out the Facebook?
Go check it out.
Yeah, go check it out. Because
I don't want to piss Shane off.
I do, but I do. I want to see him go like the blood pressure to go up to like rant to like need a minute to recoup.
He's a little
like,
under the weather right now.
I am.
He's not feeling well.
That
so.
Is true. I am under the weather.
Yeah.
Unscripted, like, you know, fuck you. Like, let's get there.
Let's go piece by piece. We're talking about the whole thing. Piece by piece, second by second. Let's break it down.
Yeah.
I think that, so.
They did tease maybe who's involved with Han in that in the generation, because it talks about generations in the TV
screen. Oh, I don't want to.
See,
right,
look at
All right, we're going to go on to 30-second we're going to the next segment, and the next segment is
30-second thoughts.
And 30-second thoughts is where we get 30 seconds to talk about a particular topic. Mm. And the first one is we're just going to go into something that we have never really done before in this, and that is the last movie that you watched. It can be old, new, watched for the first time, watched for the 30th time, whatever. What is the last movie you watched, and give a quick 30-second review of it? Mm. I'll start off with Mr. Chadwick here.
I'm going to need a little bit more than 30 seconds.
Well, you're going to try and do your best.
I'm going to try to do my best, but give me a little bit extra. All right. I watched a whole bunch of movies this week.
Go.
But the last one I watched, which I don't want to talk about, was Spectre. Because
I want you to talk about that.
It was my first 007 movie. I went open at night. Mm-hmm. I fell asleep. The best thing about the best thing about the movie was I got to see the Revenant trailer beforehand, and it looked amazing. Mm-mm. So I don't want to talk about them. The opening scene in 007 was amazing.
Yep.
And it got me excited. Like, I'm like, oh my God, this movie is going to be fucking awesome. And then it just didn't do anything awesome at all. I made it 45 minutes into the movie, which surprised me.
I'm giving you another 30 seconds. Go. What are you going
to
review?
All right. So the last movie that I watched that I actually want to talk about is a movie on Netflix. It's called Sex Ed.
Okay.
It has Haley Joel Osment in it. And it was actually pretty damn good. Like, I kept on looking at it, and I kept on, like, flicking through it. And I'm like, he was in Tusk. I liked him in Tusk. I just can't see him in this. And I watched it. It's him as a teacher, and he goes in and he has to teach sex ed to these like middle school age kind of kids. And it was actually a legit kind of funny movie and actually pretty good. And I highly recommend it.
All right. All right. So what do you give it out of your ratings?
I think I gave it a three. Three out of five.
Three out of five?
Three out of five, yeah.
All right. What about you, Brandon? What are you up to here?
Well,
what's the last movie you watched?
The last movie I watched was Tangled.
Ooh, that's a good one. That's a good animated movie.
Yeah.
Underrated.
Yeah, I was watching it with my daughter. I've seen the movie several times.
I've never seen it.
It's great. Rapunzel, like the songs in it are cool. The story's cool. It's got like a little, you know, it has that little adult little twist here and there to it. It's got a little sassy attitude every once in a while. I like it. I don't mind watching it with her, you know what I mean?
Okay. So the last movie that I watched was This Is Where I Leave You. I've watched it twice in the last 4 days. And this movie is very good. It has an excellent cast, and the chemistry together is just amazing. Like, they are just perfectly in tune with each other. It's an emotional roller coaster. Like, if you are sad and you go into this movie, you'll probably cry. If you are happy, you're going to laugh your ass off. Everybody has, like, the dysfunctional family that they have. Like, everybody has that. And watching this, it just, you can relate to it at some point in time. And it's just so incredibly well done and funny. I don't know. If you like dramedies, because I would consider this kind of a dramedy, definitely do it. It's not on Netflix, but it's well worth the rental. Like, I caught it on HBO or, you know, Showtime or something like that, recorded it. I watched it by myself. Then I watched it with my wife, and we both loved the movie. I think it's just one of those that's just...
It's one of those movies I haven't got around to watch, but I do. Jason Bateman
is so good in this movie. Tina Fey is great. Mm-hmm. Corey Stroll, Jane Fonda. They're all so good. It's just perfect chemistry. Even Rose Byrne. She's just... the movie's just great. Adam Driver. Kylo Ren. Yeah. He is in this movie, and he is... fucking hilarious.
Is he really?
He is hilarious.
I've only seen him in... I haven't seen that. I've only seen him in a couple snippets of Girls.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Girls.
I've like caught it like or whatever, and he seems like this generation's Keanu Reeves. But like, he's like really just like...
He's a good actor.
You know, I like Adam Driver more than Keanu Reeves.
He's a good actor. So that's why I think
like,
he's good.
When I first heard about being Kylo Ren and Star Wars, I'm like... No, no, don't do that. Yeah. But like, nah, like I'm trying to be open-minded as can. But my only experience to the guy is like, you know, vacant. Like, oh yeah. Oh, man.
No, he's not like that. He's not like that. He's got more levels to him than one tone. All right, next one up is next topic is Daisy Ridley has recently said that she will be doing opening weekend of Star Wars, and what she said is this. I'm going to curl up in a ball and cry and just hope people like me.
Okay. She's awesome.
So what are your 30-second thoughts on her response? I'm going to start off with Chad.
Well, you always start off with me.
Well, it's because you're a delight.
Oh, all right. I don't know much about her. It seems like she's pretty cool. I mean, it's kind of funny that she said something like that.
Yeah.
I read that she wasn't a fan of the first ones. I'm wondering if she was like...
1, 2, and 3 or 4, 5, and 6?
She said she saw the original ones and she wasn't a big fan of them.
Ooh.
But... wait a minute. She's looking forward to these ones, you know, this one coming out. And I think she's legit hoping people likes her.
She freaking cried when she saw the trailer.
Yeah,
she's
like,
bed and breakfast. What do you think?
Yeah,
what do you think, Mr. Brandon?
Yeah, I was going to say, I was just going to kind of go off of that. I watched her reaction of her watching the trailer on TV and her getting emotional and stuff like that. So, like, I think it's cool because, like, there's such this big fan following and such all this hype around this movie that I'd be kind of nervous as hell, too. They're like, it's my first real big starring role, this, you know, worldwide, not centuries, but, like, families, you know, times, you know, what, 30 years, 40 years of... you know, waiting for, you know, or this movie fan base, it's a really big deal.
Yeah. For me, I think that this franchise goes to show that they're such large juggernauts that, like, these actors want to do whatever they can to not be the next Jar Jar Binks, the next Anakin. Because they will be hated forever by this franchise, and it's bigger than ever. And They try so hard to give out great performances, and it just, like, I thought it was kind of cute and sad that she was like, I hope people like me. Like, all the comments and everything that she's made has been, you know, it's been adorable. Like, I hope that she puts out like a badass performance and she kind of encapsulate the whole role and everything. But
one thing I did like about the international trailer, we didn't see even when she was firing the gun. You see that, the blaster shot, she's like,
I only watched it once and I kind of turned my head away from the trailer a couple times.
She looks like she's giving it to it.
Yeah,
like, you know what I mean.
So, I mean, as far so far what I've seen from her performances in the trailer, she's got no worries. Like, people are gonna love her. Like, everybody in this movie, people are gonna love.
Speaking of Jar Jar Binks, did you ever read the fan theory?
I did.
Like, all that stuff about
he was like the
puppet, like the guy with the puppet.
He's like the other guy that he's the like strings. The other Darth Vader, like like he's like the other guy that's
behind,
like under the
behind
wings.
The emperor, behind
it
Palpatine.
Was really well written. I was like, you could read this and
I
be kind of like,
really hard.
All right,
yeah, like, I can see where you're going, right, but come on,
it's like, yeah, that's a big reach, but like, I was like, okay,
it was very well written.
It was very the way that they did, they told the story. They told their story of this character. It worked. You could have that work. It is
like the drunken boxing references.
Oh my gosh!
Yeah. I'm like, wow. I'm like, really? Okay.
So good. So good. I love that. All right. So the next one up is Ricky Gervais. This is Chad's little. He wanted to put this in here. He was very excited about it.
Yeah.
Ricky Gervais has joined the cast, the voice cast of Blazing Samurai, the animated family comedy from Mass Animation. The other voice casts in this movie are Samuel Jackson, Michael Cera, Mel Brooks, George Takei, Gabriel Iglesias, Azeev Manvi. I can't never pronounce this guy's Hansu. I'll say his last name. Jimon Hansu.
Yeah.
Michelle Yeoh and Sandra Singh Low. Mel B. Lots of people are in this movie. Pretty good voice cast. And this is about a scrappy dreamer of a dog named Hank, voiced by Michael Cera, Chad's boy, the laziest man on earth, who longs to become the great warrior and fights to save the town of Kakamuchu. Kakamucho. The film is inspired by Mel Brooks' Blazing Saddles, which is an amazing classic. And Gervais would voice the villainous Ika Chu, the sneaky bad cat with the grand plan to rid Kakamucho of its feline inhabitants. All right, Chad, go ahead and talk about Kakamucho.
I'm excited for this, man. Like, with that cast... with Mel Brooks being attached to it.
Yeah.
I mean, the directors of it aren't, like, known directors. I know one of them has worked on The Lion King. Did work on it. I don't know what he did, but he was in the whole process of whatever. But I can't wait for this, man. Like, it's going to be funny. I'm more excited about how Blazing Saddles was a... inspiration for a family cartoon movie. Like how are they gonna do that?
I don't know.
I don't see the connection at all, but except for the title, the blazing part, but I'm excited for it.
Cockamucho.
I can't wait.
Hashtag cockamucho. Yeah, all right, Brandon, what do you think?
Okay. I don't like Michael Cera.
Uh-huh.
Not really.
All
right. I'll respect him a lot more when he does something different.
Mm-hmm.
Beyond the...
Well, he's going to be in Fantastic Beasts somewhere. Oh, no, he's not.
No, he's not.
He's the same character.
Guess
he's
been. Sounds like a lot of work.
He's the same character he's been since Arrested Development. Like, that's it. Like, every movie he's ever been in, every role he's ever done is always the same thing.
But this is not all about Michael Cera here, you guys. There's a lot more people.
He is the lead.
He's the lead in that. That's the only thing I'm saying. So that, like, as soon as I saw that, I'm like, I'm immediately turned off.
Okay.
You know, if it was...
Even his voice turns you off?
Yeah, because
it's... Jeez.
The soothing sounds of Michael Cera. I don't hate Michael Cera.
Man.
I just...
I don't like
him. That, what he... When he turned down Fantastic Beasts, because it seems like a lot more work kind of than to do some voice work to be Robin in the Batman, you know, Lego movie.
Contract, man. You don't know.
So bad.
We already talked about that.
Yeah, so we did talk about it. Well, for me, I mean, I love everything in Mel Brooks, and Blazing Saddles is an all-time classic. The guy's a comedy legend, and I am glad that he is going to be voicing in this movie, and it's kind of based off of that movie. That's great. But as soon as I heard kind of a family friendly, I'm kind of out, because if you're going to do this with that cast, I want an R-rated animated comedy. Mm. Like, I want a really funny, it doesn't have to go that intense, but I want a funny animated comedy for adults. Like, if you're going to have Blazing Saddles, Mel Brooks is going to be in this. You know, even Michael Cera, he is known to go a little crazy. Yeah, like that. Like, he is. That was like one of the best things I've seen from him in a while. Like, it's the only thing that's taken a little departure, but he's just more poking fun at his own self.
Right.
And that's fine. But, and you have Ricky Gervais. I mean, he is one of those guys that just knows how to beat up people verbally. Yeah. And that's what I want to see if you're going to get this.
And Samuel Jackson. I mean,
motherfucker. Like, I think he has that. I think
the voice
anybody says motherfucker, I'm sure he gets some kind of like royalties from
like
it. Yeah.
Penny.
Yeah. So, I that's what I want. But obviously, if it's a family friendly, I'm too excited about it. But I hope that it's good. I do hope that it's good.
I might give it a spin, but I don't know.
Next one up. And we actually have a little thing here for it.
It's time for Random Rants and Rave Reviews.
That's right. It's time for Random Rants and Rave Reviews. And this is where we talk, rant about any random thing that's slightly related to movies, sometimes not even related to movies. Mm. We just kind of a little open format here. And we're going to start off with...
You.
Yeah, you do.
Well, you know what? I won't even start off with me. We got a little... We got something from Bill Pia.
Okay.
He wrote in, and he had said to me... Michael Keaton came out recently and said that Batman is going to destroy any superhero out there. Right. He's going to win. Like, that's just to put it short. He's the best. That's basically what he said. Nobody can beat him. Ever. Bill thinks otherwise. So Bill comes out, he's like... Superman would destroy him in like a second. Hulk gets two hands on him. He's destroying him. He's dead. I kind of went on the tangent. I was like, first of all, Hulk is never going to get his hands on him. Right. And Batman's going to use major sedatives to knock him out. And then when he is knocked out, he can do whatever the fuck he wants to him. I was like, and then Superman has one of the most vulnerable things ever. And that's kryptonite.
Yeah.
Where a 98-year-old man, asthmatic man, that's in terrible shape could destroy Superman with some kryptonite, because he just becomes this little...
And not to mention Bruce Wayne is wicked rich, so he could find something or whatever, you know what I mean?
He has so much money that he can...
Knowledge.
He has all the money he wants at his disposal. can destroy anybody. He is the most physical, he's the best physical specimen that man has ever seen. And on top of that, he is like the Sherlock Holmes of wit when it comes to, you know, deductive abilities and all that kind of stuff. He is nothing like anybody has seen.
He's in great shape. Wicked smart. Wicked rich. That's a trifecta.
I just think that he's like the better version of Lex Luthor. Like he is that physical specimen that knows all sorts. He's like nine. He specializes in like nine different kind of martial arts. He's just a perfect superhero, and he fights 32. So he's willing to go to that next realm. And he was like, well, if this was real life and, you know, Superman just wanted to like throw like his eye beams, you know, at him and kill him in a second. I was like, first of all, Batman would dodge that no problem whatsoever, because he's the only one to ever have, you know, dodged Darkseid's Omega beams. So that's just how good Batman is. So I can always come back with something that will allow Batman to overcome. The only two characters that I've ever thought that it would have give him a serious run for his money are Wolverine and Deadpool.
I was gonna say, yeah.
Because they have the regenerating, and like you could throw, you know, sedatives at them and they're gonna burn through it quicker. You can, you know, stab them with something, they take it out, it just heals. Like that's the two, especially with Wolverine, who has the senses and can smell people and, you know, from further distances and track them down. He's got the adamantium. Like I think that Batman could sneak up on him. But as far as Deadpool, Deadpool's just crazy and doesn't care if he blows up. He's just like, go ahead. Yeah. Like, go ahead, chop me in half. Let's see if this works. Like, boop. Oh, I'm growing back together. That's so cool. So like, I think that he would be a tough guy. Like those are the two guys that I think would give him the biggest run for his money. But I still think Batman would come out on top. I just think that he would. I can't see any scenario where he doesn't win. He was like, what about Luke Skywalker and Darth Vader? I was like, that's not even close. Like, come on. Like,
what about like Thanos or something like that?
I think
Apocalypse or Sinister.
He would get into their minds. Yeah. I think he's got that. I mean, he's developed like several different like blocks on his mind so that people can't get into his mind. And then on top of that, I think that he's just so smart. He would just pick them apart verbally to the point of where they would kind of be like, he would find their weakness and just destroy him. Like Lady Death. Thanos loves Lady Death. Well, let me get Lady Death in the picture here. And then there you go. Thanos is dead. Like I can't really be sold 100% that Batman is going to lose.
For the record, who is your favorite superhero of all time?
Batman.
Okay.
And Wolverine. Wolverine's up there too. Yes, and I loved the debate. I loved going back and forth. It was great having the little kind of back and forth online and everything.
Nerd out.
So I do like it. I enjoy it because I mean, I don't know. I just like talking about that shit. Yeah. Obviously. So yeah, it's fun. It's fun. So do you have anything to say about Bill Pia's little rant about Batman?
I don't know enough about it to put any kind of 2 cents into it. Like if I'm going. I mean, these guys all have like superpowers and stuff like that. Like my heroes are like the Ninja Turtles. They don't have superpowers. They can't like.
Leonardo is not taking down Batman.
They can't like shoot fucking laser beams through their eyes. And I mean, hand to hand combat, they beat them. But with all the superpowers and stuff, you can't beat superpowers with no superpowers.
On to Brandon.
Batman by himself with no superpowers or no like.
He doesn't have any superpowers.
He's been trained by the most elite
martial artists in the world and knows all of them to the level of Splinter. All those martial artists. Splinter is a fucking rat and learned it from a book. Like, I'm telling you right now, he's very good. I love Splinter, and Splinter could destroy anybody in that universe, but not so much Batman.
Didn't I tell you about they were trying to do like a hybrid like comic?
Yeah.
Batman and the Ninja Turtles.
Yeah. I'd actually like to read that. I would like to read that. Well, so what do you think, Brandon? Anything about this at all? Or we kind of touched on it.
I just kind of jumped in when I wanted to.
Yeah. All right. So what do you guys? Anything for random rants?
My one thing I told you about, like Melissa Matheson, she wrote E.T.
Passed away. She
unfortunately died a couple of days ago. I mean, 5 days ago, 6 days ago, yeah. What it was. And, I mean, I know she's not known for much except for E.T.
E.T., which is a great thing to be known for.
And being the wife of Harrison Ford. I mean, that's a big plus, too.
Yeah.
But I just thought the story of how she got around to writing E.T. was pretty interesting. She was on set of Indiana Jones visiting her then boyfriend, Harrison Ford. And it was early in the it was late at night, early in the morning, whatever. It was like, she said it was like 2 o'clock in the morning or whatever. And they're driving across the desert, just the three of them.
Yep.
Harrison Ford, her, and Spielberg. Imagine that, like standing in the middle of these guys.
Not a bad group.
Right? And Spielberg just happened to mention, you know, it would be awesome to see a movie with like this alien that came down and was like stuck here or whatever.
Yeah.
And she just, I guess it was already written, and he called her in and pretty much redid the whole thing, and everything that's E.T. is known for, she's done it. Like all the catchphrases and everything, like she's attached to all that, like E.T. phone home, like all those catchphrases that everybody knows is that knows. She's the one behind it, and it's amazing. And unfortunately, you know, something like that had to happen.
Very unfortunate.
And she was kind of young too. I mean, she was 65, I think. 65, which is not young, that's not, but it's not old either, you know. Like, right. So cancer sucks.
It does.
That's the big thing about this one.
Fuck cancer.
Seriously, cancer. I love that whole thing that Steve Amell does with Arrow and everything. Mm-hmm. He's got the shirts. It's, you know, fuck cancer, all that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. Like, it's touched almost everybody nowadays. It's not like a big rare thing. I mean, my brother had it. I mean, I'm sure everybody knows.
Everybody's affected by it.
And it's really scary, but at the same time, it seems like it's touching more and more people.
Yeah.
Hopefully they come up with some, you know, better ways to kind of tackle it.
Yeah. But I forgot to tell you guys, me and Mark Hamill are boys now.
Oh, Jesus.
He favored my tweet, literally 45 seconds. 45 seconds after.
Splice that in.
And we never even talked about that either. And that's something that we should have talked about.
Can we like try and work?
And you being a Star Wars fan, you should have definitely.
I think it's one of those things that's nice, and it was going to happen no matter what.
But it happened. Yeah. We should talk.
It was nice. I mean, it's one of those things that, I mean, we can just throw it out there real quick. I think it's like,
hopefully it's the last one, because now everybody's going to want to see it.
Yeah, I mean,
I know it's bad to say. I mean, it's horrible to say that. Like every cancer person is going to try to like. I want to see that movie.
It would splice in right there where we talked about fuck cancer and stuff like that.
Yeah, it's one of those things that I really think it's a great thing that happened.
Yeah.
And I think that's what just everybody's really going to say, is that it's a great thing that happened. I'm glad that it happened. It should have happened, and it did.
What's cool is that he got to see an unedited version.
Mm-hmm.
That's cool. I mean, that's something like,
no one else is going to see that. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like it's a one-time thing. And he got a phone call from J.J. Abrams. Like it's
cool.
Talk to him about
that's
it. Like,
really cool. They went over.
It's really cool.
They went.
The Disney people showed up and like they did it. And the internet response for it was the best part. The hashtag, you know, Force for Daniel.
Yep. Yeah.
It trended really well, and that's how.
And that's how Sir Chadwick got his
favorited.
His tweet favorited by Mark Hamill himself.
It's like 45 seconds after I posted it.
Yeah. Also known as the Joker.
Yeah. Don't bring it back.
Batman animated series.
Yeah, he's the voice actor for Joker.
I thought it was cool, but. Do you think Disney like was under a lot of pressure on it? Like if they didn't do it,
because I think they knew that they were going to do it no matter.
I'm saying they decided like no, we're not going to do this.
Yeah.
Do you think a lot of people would have like
there would have been backlash for it?
Backlash for this.
Like, I think the thing gained so much steam that if they didn't do it, they would have looked bad.
But do you think that's a problem? That's what I was trying to get at earlier.
Like, things that go viral.
Do you think it's going to go to the point where like a lot of big movies like this is going to happen now? And it's going to be like franchises and stuff like that. Is it going to happen every single time now? Or are you going to get more than just one person doing this now? Like, you're going to see a lot of people saying it now. Well, I'm dying in 2 months.
Right.
Like, can I go? I know it's sad, and it's very tough to talk about it, but...
I don't know. I mean, if they do,
is it going to get to the point where it's going to be like, no, we can't do it anymore?
Yeah.
Like,
I don't know. I don't know how many people are going to want to... it's not a waste, but how many people are going to want to have that be their last wish kind of deal? Like,
that's true too. Yeah.
I mean, not everybody. I mean, some people might want to go visit like Dubai or something like that. I saw you posting Rome how you want to go there. Or they just want to go to the Louvre, or you know, they want to do something else. Like, They want to meet their favorite author.
Like that, you know, I want to see that movie. Like, yeah. It seemed to be that guy's, you know, it's not singular, but like the masses of it, you know, would be something.
Like, I don't see like somebody coming out saying, I want to see the third Bridget Jones Diary movie that's going to be coming out soon. Can you please get me a private screening? Like, this Star Wars is a different beast.
Yeah, the fandom is a different beast. Yeah, that's why.
But if they really love Bridget Jones Diary. I don't know. But, I mean,
Renee Zellweger, you're tattooed right on my
shoulder. She doesn't look anything like she used to, but they are doing another movie, so I don't know. We'll see. I mean, I don't know where it's gonna happen, how that's gonna work out, and everything. Yeah. But what do you have anything for the quadruple R?
Yeah, maybe something. A couple of days is gonna be Veterans Day, so I just want to tip my cap to
very nice that,
you know, has served our country or still serving. And my family's been around the military my whole life. My grandfather, my stepfather's still in the Air Force and stuff like that. So
I had a lot of people actually work for me that were in the Navy and stuff like that. When I had several people that worked for me there, and like it would always be scary when they would leave, you know, and like they're gone for 6 months, and it's kind of like, man, it's so scary. Like just to know what their families are going through and all that kind of stuff. It's really scary. I'll come up with something here that's a little more. I guess I'm lighthearted.
I do have one thing I got to bring up real quick.
All right.
Because Brandon is not involved with it yet. What are our Star Wars predictions? We got five people in it so far.
No, you
haven't been in it yet. It's going to be $20. It's all going towards a charity. Whoever is the closest to guessing the opening weekend of Star Wars Episode 7 domestically.
Okay.
Opening weekend.
Price is Right rules? Like closest without going over?
Whoever's the closest.
It's just whoever's closest, plus minus.
Okay. What are the
two decimal
other
points
ones that have been there?
Are we allowed to show the other numbers, or? I don't think we are.
I just need reference because I don't deal with it as much as you guys do, like the numbers.
I'll give you the range,
box
right?
Office or
I'll
whatever,
give you the range.
Blah, blah, blah.
The lowest right now.
22.
Okay.
22, you know, 222 million.
Yeah.
And the highest is 310
million. What did Avatar do?
Avatar did like 70 million open weekend.
What did
it just?
What did Ultron do?
Because
Ultron did
inflation.
It didn't break the Jurassic World is the world record holder right now, and it was like one. I said one away. 208 million.
Yeah. 234. Even, or
a lot of movies go over.
Throw two numbers in there.
Yeah.
So 208,
234.44.
Right, so you think it's gonna barely break? I'm still on the fence that it's gonna break Avatar.
Yeah.
But I think if there's one that has a chance, I think this is gonna be it.
I mean, we got high numbers, me and you. Mm. And Wayne is.
Wayne went above me.
Let's talk about Wayne. You and Wayne.
I had to mention that.
Jumping on me for the last show or whatever. Let's open this up. Brought someone on the show who looks like
ding 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 ding.
It was clear the air here.
You brought someone on the show who looks like every bad John Malkovich character. You can have.
Don't make fun of him. Don't make fun of him.
He said, "Fuck me." He said, "Yeah, I don't know that guy. Fuck him." So I can throw. I'll throw one shot at him, and that's it. He looks like a mixture of Teddy KGB with a tracksuit and the star when he was in
Old School Wayne,
the Transformers movie with a ponytail.
Old School
pulled
Wayne.
Down. That's
Old
it.
School Wayne.
That's
man,
it. I had no problem with what
he's
he
a fan favorite.
That's it. Because I don't like Anna Kendrick, I got like, oh, that's the same. We got beef right now. Yeah, fuck that guy.
I don't think that was the whole thing. But
it was kind
of the whole thing. The whole thing was is you said something without me on the show. And
that's
what started it, because you said something.
You were like,
me
come at me,
here.
Bro. Like,
because you were in Maine?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I wasn't on the show to back myself up.
What did I say? Oh, about that part, I don't even think you have to roll the tape on where the beef comes from. You can like lace all that shit
together. I'll see if I can come up with something.
I know
where does camera one surface?
Only camera one today.
And Anna Kendrick.
Hathaway?
No, we can just bag on Anna Kendrick because she's not here.
Good for Chad.
Yeah. And it's like Anna Kendrick, Kristen Stewart. Okay, come at me, bro.
Trying to be more like what, Brandon?
Brandon, yeah.
Yeah. He was trying to.
Me and Brandon got beef right now, by the way.
I don't even know the guy.
25.
Welcome.
You heard it.
Fuck you, Brandon.
I'm with Team Chad, okay?
Hashtag Team Chad. Chad
hashtag,
on Twitter.
Hashtag that. You went on an Anna Kendrick tirade without me being here, and you just said, come at me, bro, or whatever you said, yeah. without me being here.
Did that make the final cut? Because I don't think that made the cut.
I don't know if it made the final cut.
Yeah, so no one else knows what we're talking about, except maybe like you had to send him the editor. And you, don't think you're getting off scot-free with this either.
What are you talking about?
You put up the worst possible picture for me for that episode. You pick up like, I was dressed up like Zach Morris for my 90s like Halloween party, and you pick that thing to like take a jab at me back.
That was a good picture.
And he's the one that instigated the whole fucking thing too.
So I'm just like, oh, whatever.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
All right, we cleared the air.
I love everyone.
We love everybody. Everybody loves everybody.
We bust each other's balls online. He's a troll. He gets it back from time to time. Plus, we're football fans in the same division, so we don't get along in that instance.
Well, this year I don't care because my Lions suck. So.
Well, I got two games of awfulness with my team. So. Mm-hmm. Packer fan. Oh, yeah.
Anything else?
Speaking of which, yeah.
And just one more thing.
Yeah, do go. Are you in fantasy football?
If you're a fantasy football guy,
yeah, please.
And you have Aaron Rodgers on the team.
Shane.
Don't. Ever sit him. I don't care if you sit him once and, oh, you made the right decision. Now you're going to make the right decisions all the time. It's going to fucking bite you in the ass because you're going to overcoach. I don't care if you got Phillip Rivers.
I don't even play fantasy football and I wouldn't do that.
Yeah, you don't sit. Aaron Rodgers is a first round draft pick.
Mm-hmm.
You don't sit your first round draft pick ever.
Ever. It's
ever. I don't care who they're playing. I don't care. It's Aaron fucking Rodgers.
That's right.
Aaron fucking Rodgers.
Who cares about Phillip
Who has
Rivers?
60 less fantasy points than Phillip Rivers.
You don't go
this
by
year.
That.
Yeah.
You don't go by that.
You don't go by fantasy points?
Ride that luck out. See where it lands you in the playoffs when the real games start.
Then I'll start Aaron Rodgers.
Oh! And then you're going to lose. I'm just letting you know right now, I don't ever sit Aaron Rodgers.
Mm-hmm.
It's called overcoaching. And anybody that plays fantasy games knows about overcoaching.
Mm-hmm.
And you just can't overcoach. You want to do it, and you're going to do it. I do it, too. But
I will ride the wave of Phillip Rivers until he proves me otherwise.
It's like even though Peyton Manning sucked all year.
Intended.
Fucking Eli Manning.
Fantasy. I love football. That's why I don't play fantasy, because I want to root for my team.
Well, I love football, too. I mean, I watch it every week. And
I don't want to stress out about all the games. I don't want to stress out about my team.
I like stressing about games. Love it.
You should play FanDuel.
No.
I do.
Fuck FanDuel. You got better things to spend your money on.
Yeah.
I mean, we can go out to dinner or something. Take me out for dinner. Take us out for dinner.
That won't give me any pleasure.
Well, they'd give us pleasure. Maybe
give you easy. Pause.
Maybe a little under the table.
See, you went there. I was like, I even stopped you before you did it, and you went there anyway.
I'm gonna go there.
Pause.
All right. So on this week. We covered a lot.
Not enough.
And well, that's pretty much it. So where can people find you, Chad?
Instagram. And Twitter and Facebook, all at DJDizzle82.
DJDizzle82.
And on Snapchat
put it up
at SirChadwick82.
SirChadwick82. You can find me, obviously,
yeah. The
CineBros, everywhere.
Never
For
more.
Brandon, where can people find you?
All at Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, all at DJ Darth Vader.
Got it right below, at DJ Darth Vader. No E on the end of Blaine.
Right.
No. I did that once.
Oh, you put the E.
I did.
Oh, you also put the E at the end of the crow too. Like
you know why? Because that's right there. So, Russell Crowe. Yes. So when I'm editing, I probably had that on my brain. Like it's just I was an idiot. Whatever. It happens.
How do you spell crow? Oh, it's right there in front of me. All right.
It's just that's what I had going on because we talked about Russell Crowe in that show too.
I think so.
But anyway, you can find me everywhere at the CineBros.
Mm-hmm.
YouTube.com/the Movie House Maniacs.
Subscribe.
Mm-hmm. Where is that? It's right here. Boom. YouTube.com/the Movie House Maniacs. Below that, you can see Facebook.com/the CineBros, where you can find all of like the stuff that we post on a daily basis and stuff like that. Chad posted something the other day about the Oscar. Early predictions and everything, which I was thinking about getting into during the random rants, but we can do that another day because that's. We got some time.
We got a lot of movies.
I think February 28th is when they're coming out this year.
We got a lot of movies to see, Shane.
Yeah. I'm 2015, I'm up to 43 movies that have come out
but
this
we're
year.
I'm talking Oscar movies. How many of those movies have you seen?
I've seen...
That were on my list. Obviously, some of them haven't come out yet, so we haven't seen them, but...
I would say a third?
Have you seen that many of them?
Yeah, I've seen a lot. Maybe a little less, a quarter. Revenant. Can't wait to see it.
Dude, I'm thinking about going to New York to see it, like opening weekend.
I would consider doing that.
It's the only thing that sucks is it opens Christmas.
Yeah, well, you can do it the 24th, Christmas Eve, but that's tough. That's tough. I do stuff on Christmas Eve. I don't know. All right, so that's it for episode 23. I have a lot of editing to do because I had to get this down to about an hour and 15 minutes. I think we're at about an hour and 40. So I will see you guys again at the movies soon. And thank you guys for coming on.
I'll see you next episode.
If you watch the show on YouTube, please click that thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. And thank you for watching.